Hello and welcome back. We're playing Eve again. Now, this is the first episode of series Noob Survival Guide in Eve. Yes, as you heard, I'm a noob, if you don't know. So, I cannot fly like this. This ship cannot be flied like this. If I jump one gate, I'll die. So I need some set of eyes so I can use my to pilot my ship better. Now, the first set of eyes, if you look here on scanners and you press it, you'll have two scanners. Well, three actually. This I never used. Now, this scanner, directional scanner, is your life, your ship's life. Let me explain. You click it and boom, disappears. Now, when you press scan, it scans, you see, on a direction. On a direction you look in space, it scans. At an angle of 15 degrees. Now, we won't use it at 15 degrees, we'll use it at 360 degrees. That means we can see all over around our ship at a distance of 14 AU. What's an AU? It's the distance from the Earth to the Sun, and that is how it's calculated here in Eve. The number of kilometers, 1 AU is the number of kilometers from the Earth to the Sun. So we can measure space. Now, here on the overview, the ships and the objects are under 1 AU, so they are measured in kilometers. Now, if you see this big circle around me, this is the directional scanner. And when I press scan, you scan everything around you, and here in this window you see all what is around you. Gates, stations, wrecks, ships. Well, we're in Isaac and here is a lot of noise. Anyway, if you click one here, you'll see the ship. What kind of ship it is? This is a Venture. Now, this scanner can be used to pinpoint ships in space, but this is not the case right now. We'll use the directional scanner for defense. You see? Now, all around us. One thing is that the game puts automatically that directional scanner window, puts it with the system map. We don't need that. We separate the D scanner from the system map to use it independently, so we can scan whenever you want. So if you see, usually when you are in low security, no security, or a wormhole space, and you see a ship here, that means you want to move. And depends on the ship you find, the distance it is. Now, this, it's a big range. Normally, it's better to keep it at 5 AU. That is enough when you scan. You know that the ship is coming in, warping in. Now, you can choose to move up and down. Now, the trick is that I don't like the button that directional scanner use, and we're gonna make some key changes right now. We go to settings. Now this settings is, well, I don't like the mouse zoom, so I use invert mouse direction. And let me show something else which bothers me, so we can have a smooth flight. Now, if I press on something, the radio channel, and hold left click, the radio channel appears. I don't like the radio channel. And even if I put like this, and this can bother you sometimes in a stressful situation when you want to avoid some things on fly, and I don't like to use it. So I go here in settings, go to general settings, and radial menu channel, radial menu, I'll put the middle mouse. I'll never use it, but I know it's there. Now at shortcut, so I can use the scanner, directional scanner, faster, I type here scan, and you see the directional scanner, it's put on V. Well, for me it's very hard to find that button. So there is a big button on your keyboard called space, and I'll use that. Reassign. Now if we return to game, in for example, we have the directional scanner, you just put it, appears and scans again, and because it's a big button on your keyboard, you can press it very easy from every direction and scan. It's very good to scan 10 times a minute. I now when you're in high sec, it's not that important, but I got used to it, and I press it even if I am in high sec, high security space. Now let me change some more keys, because I don't like it. Scan. Now probe scanner, increase scan range. This is X. Probe scanner. Decrease. And refresh. Here, see. Okay, now we're set up to the keys. Well, you can keep this or this, but this is better. And like this. Here is the type of the ship. You need to learn what these symbols mean. This is frigate. This is a big ship that carries cargo around. So you know what kind of ship there are without knowing what it is. You don't have to know every ship, but those symbols symbolize the type of the ship. If you go here in ships, ship 3, you'll see here, this is a corvette, this is a frigate, destroyer, cruiser, battle cruiser, and so on. Now, so it's more easier to understand. See, battle cruiser, destroyer. You don't have time when you're flying in high situation, you don't have time to put the mouse and look what it is, because you lose your ship like that. Anyway, now if you switch on local, we see here that another information we get out of this, that are seven a lot of people. I don't know how to pronounce this right now. There are a lot of people, of this number of people in this system. So we show compact. Now, why? What is this useful? We'll take it out because it's a useful thing to us to know. Usually when you fly in low sec, null sec, you'll be alone on this channel on, and only your name will pop. My name is... here I am. Only your name. And you see here, it will be 1. And suddenly you're in that system and you see 5 other guys enter all at once. That can mean it's a fleet coming in. A roaming fleet that wants to kill, to PvP or kill a helpless noob in distress. Anyway, that information is very good, that you'll see the names popping in and this list making bigger and bigger. So you know, if they leave, they disappear, and so on. And that's why you need the local to be alone from the other chat. Let's close the rookie channel, it's too many noise. Now, here we have the afterburner. Now ships can equip afterburners and or micro warp drives. They are used to go faster. If you see, if the afterburner isn't on, you have that speed for 366 meters of per second. If it's on, you have almost 600 meters per second. And why do we want that? Because this is a very useful fit on our ship, not fit, module on our ship, which should keep it the first. Now this every module can be used. If you can see, if you hover the mouse over, we can press F1 and that module is on and off at our desire. Now this is the core probe launcher. I don't think we'll have to use it right now, but anyway. And now this is a blaster, civilian blaster. We'll put it F2. Well, on this ship we'll never use it. Now you see this window right here, this is called an overview. How this window is important when you fly in Eve. Now if you look all around you, you see a number of objects. This is the station, and if you zoom out, you see other things in space like this ship, but we don't know where it is. What you see here in space, you see here on the overview. And this is very useful because you don't have to look around to click it. And if, let's say, a ship come from behind, you don't have to look behind. You just look here, you see the distance, you can lock it if you want. Let's lock it on. No, it's too far. Anyway, you can lock it, you can look at it. This is Jack Riley's Velator. Anyway, and so on. And it's very useful. Now, the thing is, this menu can be tweaked very much, but as a new player, and even if you are an old player, this window, you cannot tweak it so much that will be so useful. So what I found, I have it here. Utilities notepad, you can put this here if you want, I always have it. And I have here the overview. Now, you just copy this or type this in open new channel window. And you type it here. I just copy paste. Z-S space overview and click join. Now, when you join this channel, you'll enter this channel. You'll see a lot of people here. They all here not for chatting, but mainly for this. Now watch this, what I'm doing. Overview settings, it says go to misc tab, reset all overviews and click their core pack. Now we just click here, overview settings, go to misc, like it said, reset all overview settings. We click S and it resets. Now watch how the overview will change. We go here down and I have this saved, so I if I need to use it again, it will make more easy. We click core, we click yes, and this will change. You see the ships now are marked with white, so it's easier to distinguish between objects, gates and ships. Now we use this scan again, PVX1, PVX2 and standard this and it's done. We close this and we close this. Now if you can see right now, we have more tabs, friendlies, waypoints, and if it's a lot of noise here, you can go here and only select the gates and the stations to warp to. If you're mining, you can put another tab, mine, okay, and right click here, load a preset, mining all, and you'll have mining too. Okay, now when you right click over here, you have a lot of commands for your ship: approach, orbit, keep at range, look at track, pilot, bin. This is the info. Now these settings you have over here too, and sometimes it takes a couple of seconds to right click and open this menu, so it's easier for you to have this not up there but down here. And if you need to for example, you lock this, it's already locked. Well, okay, I don't know how this got here, but we'll put it here. You got this locked, you just dock orbit you have here, and you can press it, spam it like this instead of right click. And especially it's very good, especially when you come out of warp, you cannot right click and see if you can, but you can spam this and lock target or doing a lot of things. Now another thing that this menu needs is like this. We have a lot of noise and we have here a lot of things that we don't need, really need. Like you see here, we have the information over here. how many meters, how many kilometers, the distance. But we don't know this ship if it's going away or coming to us. So doesn't help us, really help us, that we know the distance between us and, let's say, this ship. Now, because we don't know, there are things. Here, all the ships, let's say Corporation Alliance, but you don't really need, I don't really need to know the corporation. If someone in corporation and alliance appears, that they will be marked blue, so you don't have to worry about that. So there is a thing that we can do, overview settings, and we can do to tab presets, appearance columns here, and we take out alliance and corporations. Now that we get out that of the way, we have some information here. This is the velocity. The velocity means the speed that you saw us like this of the ships, of the ship, enemy ship, friendly ship, any ship that is. Now we know the speed, but we don't know if the ship's coming to us or going. So this angular and transversal velocity we don't really need. We are noobs anyway, and we can take it out. What do we need is radial velocity. Now radial velocity show the same speed, only it has a minus. And when it has a minus, you know that ship is coming to you. And if it has a plus, that means that ship is going away. And you don't have to look all over the place like this and take the ship and look like this. Is it coming? Is it not coming? Anyway. Okay. And we can put the menu like this. And it's very useful. Here is the type of the ship, but you should learn this, the signs, and here will tell you what ship it is, but here is the class. Now this is the name of the ship. It's better to always set a name, because the enemy, the allies, or who sees you in space don't know what kind of ship it is, if he doesn't know the type or this. Yeah, let's close this. Now, this will be putting like here. And there is one other scanner that we will use. The probe scanner also will take this out of the and put it right here. In the next video we'll be using it. And we are almost done to fly in space here. Now there is the tactical overlay. Here it shows, when you click, it shows where you click, and the ship will start moving, you'll see. And we'll hold this. Now let's unlock this. And if we go up, you'll see this ship. Say it says with minus. Now it's with plus, that means it's going away. But this tactical overlay, you don't have it on all the time, so it's better here to look. Now, there is one thing. Oh, this window is always in the way. Let's drag it. Okay, we put it there. It's out of the way. Now, there is one thing that we have to do. Now, here in space you can save locations, bookmark stuff. For example, you can save this location. You type here save and you have a safe location. Now, this location you can see them if you press F9. Let me close the directional scanner so you can see better. And some, I don't know where I saved it. Well, it's here. Now you see here is the location, but let's make another one. You can do that in the map too. Save too. See, you see it here. But so you cannot open the map here. You can right click and hold locations and you find them, and you can warp to zero if you want. Now it comes very handy when you bookmark a lot of things in the system, so you can move around. You cannot warp, let's say you right click here and you cannot warp there. You need to warp to an object. Always warp to an object. And if a player knows that, oh, which object you move, will come after you because he'll see it here on the overview. But if you have a save location, because you can save locations in here if you want, between this you can save a location here and he doesn't have that locations. Usually he doesn't have your location. You can escape him for a couple of minutes, I don't know, 10 minutes, because there are ways he can find you anyway, but that come with a help. So if you press plus and L, this windows appear with save locations like here, and you put this window here, so you have access more easy, and you have two windows, and it's more easier, convenient for you to right click. And as you warp, you see when you warp you cannot give a command here. So my ship starts to warp. You see, this can, always this can. And when you come out of warp and you need to, let's say you go there and you see ships appear that are unfriendly, you can always do this. Well, this, and warp back. You don't know, click here, location here, warp, you can stumble and lose your ship, so it's more convenient here. Now, I hope you like this video. Now, I should say all this information and how I fly the ship, usually in Eve. I didn't magically invent it. I watched and gathered a lot of information from players on YouTube, players in game that I've talked about, and on Discord as well. So take care and see you in the next video.